Welcome to another animation tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to animate with Midjourney. Are you having a laugh? No, I am serious. Common sense made simple.
Wait, Midjourney doesn't animate.
So this is Midjourney. If you've been living under a rock and you have no idea what it is, it's a text to image AI art generator. It's improved a lot. As you can see, they integrated Stable Diffusion. Like, wow, look at, hey, Vin Diesel, what's the matter, you want? But, I don't know, does he talk like that? But, yeah, see, it's some amazing stuff, but I'm not here to show you how to do this because you can do all this in Stable Diffusion. This is the type of style I feel a lot of people think Stable Diffusion is just too realistic, and they like this whole AI classic Midjourney style, and Disco Diffusion had a similar style. And so the AI model that was custom trained we'll be using today is based on this classic Midjourney style, and I'll be showing you how to use that to animate both with the Deforum Google Colab Notebook and also automatic 1111's webUI. So here we are in a Deforum Notebook, simplified. It's to use Midjourney. You're my member, I'll give you access to it. So here we are, I clicked on some of this already because as you know, they added the whole compute system. So the time, the clock set again, get your wallet out.
Money, money, money,
so yeah, that's been a big disappointment for a lot of people. But so you don't really, the tier system means nothing. Pro, plus, you can do background education, execution if you're a millionaire. And so I just buy the credits as I need them. I have the A100, I already ticked it to save time. If you've never used a Colab notebook before, you know, I have other tutorials on that. I'll post links in the description. So I ticked on this, gave me an A100 because I'm spending the big bucks, and clicked on that. So models, clicked on that. Now this is where it's changing. So normally it's set to whatever, SDV14. We're gonna put it on custom because we want to use the MJ model, Midjourney, I mean. And you would go to, in your folders, Drive, AI, Model, that's where I keep all mine. And as you can see, I have a bunch of them here, but we're gonna use the MJ, Michael Jordan model, Midjourney, I mean. And you would just copy the path and put in here, and now it'll know to read that. So as I record this, you see I have a ton of models. I actually have a lot more now, and I've been training more and acquiring more. And if you're one of my members, you can have any or all of them to use for yourself. And I plan on continuing to add more and more as the time passes. You got that in there, you ticked on this box. Now it's gonna look at that specific model, but there's a little more to it. Let's get into animation. I haven't made an animation in a while. The first animation tutorial I made was on the Deforum Notebook 0.1. I guess they're on 0.5 now, so we'll go over it again real quick. We're just gonna do 2D to keep it simple. 667 max frames, neighbor of the beast, angle. I'm not gonna do all the keyframes and all that. I just go over the basics real quick. So 1.3, so it'll rotate a little bit. 1.06, so it'll zoom in a little bit. I turned all these to zero. These you don't even need to know. That's for 3D only. And recently they put in a math equation here that makes everything go wobbly. So just get rid of that. All this, you don't need any of this crazy stuff. And noise schedule, I turned it to zero. It just adds a little bit of grain and noise. I do that in post. Strength schedule, I just made it to 6 because I don't know, that's how my brain works. Contrast, you don't need to worry about, don't need to worry about this. Depth warping, that's for 3D only, so you can ignore all that. Video input, we're not using a video. Interpolation, resume animation, all that you can skip. So here we are to the prompts. See, another thing, if you're tired of paying for Midjourney, you could also do it this way and not have to pay Midjourney anymore. Just start paying Google Colabs instead. So this is the prompt I used. Portrait of Cobra Commander, dramatic lighting, tone mapped, intricate, elegant, highly detailed, digital painting, art station. Oh yeah, I used art station, watch out. Concept art, smooth, sharp focus illustration. Are you getting all this?
That's a lot, business.
Right? But I figure it's perfect for a Midjourney prompt because they likes to be long. So this art journal, my boy, Greg Rutkowski, the most famous non-AI artist I know, and then everyone's favorite poster artist. But this is where you need this trigger word or token. People use different different names for it, but you need to enter every different custom AI train needs their own thing. And this one's particularly is Midjourney art style. So you have to have that at the end. You don't even need the comma, but I put it in there anyway, because I have OCD. And so let's go back up. We'll tick on that. Tick on your prompt. And then we go through the settings. I usually like to go 704 by 704. Sometimes it might give you a little mirroring, but I don't know, 512 by 512 is what the model was originally trained on, all training. Stable Diffusion models, and but I don't like it. So I'm just going seed 66. Now, this is another thing. If you really want that classic Midjourney style, the DDIM is just the sampler they were using back then. So that's, you'll get more of that look. Steps, I just 130, why not? Let's get crazy. 16, yeah, we're going there. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Type in, don't need to worry about this. Type in where it's gonna save. I just gave myself a plug, because why not? And you don't need a mask, you don't need this. Got everything going, and we're gonna watch this together. Because why watch it alone? Nobody wants to be alone. Some people like to be alone.
I like being alone.
But this is what I'm talking about. Look at that. Look at that speed. That's the A100. But at this point, I should already know Cobra Commander. If you don't know who Cobra Commander is, I think they made a bunch of movies about G.I. Joe recently, but I remember him from the 80s when there's cartoons and all that war propaganda they were trying to push on us. Well, here he is. Look at that coolness, little grimy Midjourney style. And all right, at this point, I'm going to shut my mouth and we'll watch this together. I don't even know what it looks like either. And I'll put it into a time lapse. All right. I mean, you pretty much get the point. You see the credits. Look at him going away. But you get the point of this. So I'm just going to stop it early. Just to show you, if you want to just make it right into a video, go to here, set your frames per second, click on that, make you a quick little video. Let's see how it looks. I like to take my PNG sequences and bring them into After Effects and all that, but let's see, right out of the box, if it works, there we go. Cobra. Cool. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Hopefully I didn't go too fast. I started making this a week or two ago, and at the time, no one was showing. I was wondering why everyone loves Midjourney, and no one was showing anyone how to use custom models to do this in a Midjourney style way. But now I dream with Dream Boots and everything. Everybody's kind of training their own models. I mean, I'm pushing my own models. Everyone loves models until you take them out to dinner and they're like, what the hell, are you gonna eat something? But so next I'll show you how to do this for free locally with the automatic 1111111 webUI. All right, I'll see you there. So here we are in the automatic 111 webUI. It's totally free. I'll post the link in the description if you don't already have this downloaded. But today we're going to be going over how to use the Midjourney trained model to animate. Here I just showed you how to do it in the Deforum Colab Notebook. And now I'll show you how to do it here. At the time when I started this tutorial, nobody was showing this, which I was surprised because everybody loves Midjourney. But hopefully by the time I release this, there won't be 35 tutorials on, and then in a week, I'm sure there will be. So at the moment though, here we go. First thing is the models, you know. I'll show you a pic, it should pop up now, where I place my custom models. But it'd be wherever you have your web UI set up and models, Stable Diffusion. At the time right now, I have a bunch of them here. I'll be adding more, I'm still training more. They're out there. I'll give all these to my members, whoever wants them. You can download them, use them for whatever purpose. Today, we're gonna be using the Midjourney, AKA Michael Jackson, Michael Jordan. I don't know any other buddy relevant those initials these days. If you do, please let me know in the comments. So I found this text prompt here, close up profile, futuristic cybernetic Mayan warrior in full headdress in the style of Russ Mills, Aaron Horkey, Rads, Art Germ. I don't know, I just found that online. I'm not that original. But the thing is, when you use these custom trained models, you have to add this trigger phrase or token or whatever. So in this case, it's Midjourney art style. You don't even need the last comma, but I put it in there anyway. I have all these settings I've done already. It works best with the DDIM sampler. That's what the original old school Midjourney used. But in this instance, I'm going to use Euler A just because version 3 of the animator script is not compatible with DDIM.
I'd like to show you version 3 today, and DDIM, though, will get you the closest to the classic Midjourney IM, as I also recommend
the Deforum portion of this tutorial. So we'll let this load up as I go over a couple of things. This was the seed I went for this. I woke up today open for clip aesthetic. I'm sure Nerdy Rodent is in his mom's basement right now recording a tutorial on it. I don't know how he's so quick on it, but I'm not going to go over that. I'm sure he will, and it'll be a great tutorial. So keep an eye out for that Nerdy Rodent fella. He's fun. And so yeah, CVG 13. I mean, I raised the 704 by 704. And we got this cool image, I think. Look at that little weird eye and everything. But you see how it has more of that classic Midjourney, like disco diffusion type style. A lot of people like are still into. They feel Stable Diffusion is just way too realistic, and it kind of ruins the whole aesthetic. So here we go. We got this. Send it image to image. Now it's over here. And this is where the script animator, I had a tutorial originally where I show you the original version. Now they're on version 3, which added rotation, which is amazing, and made the keyframe portion a lot more complicated. I was gonna try to dive deeper today on it, but I feel this is already running too long, so I'm gonna do a whole tutorial explaining the animator version 3 very soon for everybody. So we have this here, as you see, it carried over all the steps, boom. CVG, we'll have to readjust to our original, which was 13. Height's good, steps are good. We're using this seed, ignore this new thing. I have an MP4, but it's gonna make a PNG sequence of your animation. Now, I haven't done this yet, so we're both gonna be watching this together. I'll just hit generate. Engage. And I mean, I don't know if I've gone over this part. The text, watermark, letters, words, negative prompts. This tries to keep that out of your picture. And then obviously this. So I'll be quiet, or maybe I'll complain, or maybe I'll rant a little more, but this will go into a time lapse and we'll both be watching this together. Hopefully it turned off my screensaver. If not, you might see a little bit of a blinky blink.
Now, what I was talking about earlier with the samplers, in Animator version 3, does not accept the DDIM sampler.
All right, so it's almost done here. And I forgot to mention too, so I've been going through this so quick because I've already kind of done a quick tutorial over all this. But as you can see, the zoom factor 1.6, it is every second will double. And so if I did 2.0, it would double in size. For example, rotation, I did 25. So every second I'll rotate 25 degrees. I think counterclockwise, if it's negative, it's clockwise. And Y is up and down, X is left and right. So when it's done, it gives you this, wherever you put your stuff to save will be here. You can go down. And then the new version, it actually gives you the settings, kind of like a notebook, which is nice. Or if you want to make a GIF or an MP3 or a WebM. But let's just do that. For example, if you have your FFF MPEG put in, now you'll have, as usual, it's on my other screen. And it makes a quick video for you. So now you have a Midjourney style AI animation.
What is this?
And you can do this with any custom models you trained or you acquired. I'd love to see what you're creating with all this. Tag me, and any questions, leave them in the comments. I hope this helped you out, and have a great day.
iamYork.com.